Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel, Spit to the Beat Podcast. I recently visited Jamaica and had an incredible experience visiting the legendary Bob Marley's home. Today, I want to share with you all my experience and what I learned about the life and the music of this iconic artist. Our tour guide took us on a journey through Bob Marley's home, which is now a museum dedicated to his legacy. I was able to see where he lived, composed his music, and even learn some interesting facts about his personal life. But the highlight of this story or this trip was definitely the interview I had with our tour guide. She shared some fascinating insight about Bob Marley's upbringing, his rise to fame, and the impact his music had on the Jamaican culture and beyond. It was truly an awe-inspiring to be in the same place where Bob Marley lived and created music. I could feel the energy and the atmosphere surrounding his legacy. I hope you all enjoyed this glimpse into my visit to Bob Marley's home. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in my next video. Oh, don't forget to like and subscribe to my YouTube channel, Spit to the Beat Podcast, for more music and culture experience.
Hi everyone, this is Yvonne. I'm a tour guide.
Oh, okay. Okay, I'm a tour guide that takes people all around, especially to Bob Marley House, his mausoleum where he was born and laid to rest. Now, as I always say, Bob Marley is not just a king of legend. Not for reggae music. For reggae music, yes, but he was a very has an impact on all of our lives, not just in Jamaica, but abroad, all over. He puts reggae music on the map. And so his music will always live on. Now, as a country boy, growing up in 9 miles, going into Trenchtown, that's just where his music begins. Now, his first song was One Cup of Coffee, which is actually something different from what the reggae music he sings turns in, you know. So this album, Exodus, is one of the best-selling albums in the world. Stays on the UK chart for 52 consecutive weeks. Yes, as a Rastafarian, he was a vegetarian. And all his kids, most of them are still in the music industry. He has 11 kids, biological. And of course, unfortunately, we lost him on the 11th of May, 1981, from cancer.
Can you tell me a little bit more about Bob Marley's personal life as far as, you know, his marriage and stuff like that?
Well, he got married to Rita Marley in 1966, which remains as the queen until today. She's still around and about. And with her, he has 4 kids.
So she's still living, right?
She's still alive.
Is she here in Jamaica or she resides somewhere else?
She moved to Ghana many years ago, and she settles in Ghana.
Tell us a little bit about Bob Marley's parents. His father and his mother.
Well, Sinella Marley was his mom, passed on a couple years after Bob Marley, and his dad was not Jamaican. He was somewhere from Scotland or somewhere from the UK. So he has little or no knowledge what I've heard about his dad, as he left when he was 5 years old and he died when he was 10.
So what is his kids are doing today? You said they are in the music industry. So what are they doing now?
Well, Ziggy Marley continue music, of course. Junior Gang continue music. And, you know, some of them are still in the movie business, you know. Like, there's some movies you like Shutter. You can watch it. Yes, that's one of Bob Marley's songs. So
let's talk a little bit about the movie that came out of Bob Marley's life. What's your perception of it?
My perception of it is that it was what it is, you know. A lot of people may have different views about it, but they did a good job.
They did, okay. Also, final question. What do you think about Bob Marley's being a revolutionary has changed the culture and the thinking of the people in Jamaica? How do you think that Bob Marley's being labeled as a revolution changed the culture and the nature of the people here in Jamaica? Did it make them more independent?
Actually, it actually built your self-esteem to more believe in yourself. And of course, you know, it doesn't matter what walks of life you're coming from. If you get the drive and ambition, you can make it. Now, he was a storyteller. His music impacted a lot of people worldwide. And so, you learned a lot from it.
Is this, Bob Marley celebrated each year, I'm assuming, correctly. Is there a special day in Jamaica that they celebrate Bob Marley?
Actually, there's not yet, but not yet. We don't have a Bob Marley Day yet. I don't know if we will have one, but what I do know, it's in the making of making him one of Jamaica's national hero.
Oh, wow. I just assumed he probably had a day just like most celebrity.
We celebrate his birthday every 6th of February. You know, he was born on the 6th of February, 1945. So every 6th of February, they do have a birthday bash for him, both in 9 Miles and at his first house, which is now the museum in Kingston.
Last question. How do you feel that the kids in Jamaica and all over the world have embraced Bob Marley and his music?
Well, so far my experience with that is that we have to pass it on. As the music goes on, the things changes, then we have to introduce them and, you know, let them know about Bob. You know, they do have though. They might not know much about Bob, but they will know about his music because it will continue.
Oh, great, great. Thank you so much for being on Spit to the Beat podcast.
My name is Yvonne, and it was all a pleasure meeting you.
Are you a rich man?
When you mean rich, what do you mean?
You have a lot of possessions, a lot of money in the bank.
Position make you rich? I don't have that type of richness. My richness is life forever.